Hi, I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Berry by my students, and today is a special mini lesson. There's many questions that the students have asked me. I'm going to take five of those questions and answer them today. Question number one is basically how to set up a network printer so that you can print from your Chromebook to it. So we're going to look at setting up a real network printer today, and that's the very first question. The next question starts at 11 minutes in, and that one is how to see a video on one side of the screen and do the project on the other side of the screen so that you have both the video playing and your project, your work, on the other side. So I'm going to show you how to do that. And then we have question number three, which starts in at 14 minutes, 45 seconds. And that was about when you're inside of Google Docs or inside of Google Sheets or the other applications, you can hide the menus. So I'm going to go over how to show or hide the menus with the shortcuts or with keys on your keyboard. Then we have question number four, which is coming up at 16 minutes, 30 seconds in, and that is, which Chromebook do I recommend for you to buy? And so I do have a recommendation on which one, and it is the Acer Chromebook 15 CB5-571. At 16 minutes, 30 seconds, I'm going to show you why that one is there. And then the last question is, do I have any pets? And the answer is yes, I do. And you actually get to see them today. Alrighty, all on this mini lesson. For this demonstration, I'm using the Brother Color Laser Printer. And the model I chose was the HL3170CW. And I chose this one not only because it had good reviews and because it's a color laser. I'd only go with color laser. Laser has toner, which the powder does not dry out, which is a good thing. So it lasts a long time, and that's what we want. We want it to be economic. So this is the most economic way to go is with a color laser printer. And I also chose this one because of the screen. It has a little screen here so that you can very easily set up your Wi-Fi. Well, first off, you plug it into power. And that's all I did back here was I just plugged into power. Notice the network and the USB are both unplugged. I'm not plugging those in right now. Don't need to. And the next thing I'm going to do now is set up this to go on my network, so I have to find the SSID. How do you find that? Well, I'm going to click on OK, and it comes up to machine info, but I'm going to go up the steps here. WLAN, now that's the one that I want. I want WLAN, or just WLAN. And then we click on OK. Then I'm going to click up. It says TCIP. Nope. WLAN enable. Set to default. MAC address. WLAN status. And I just keep on going until I say setup wizard. Now once it says setup wizard, I click on OK. And it says searching for SSID. Now that's your network that you have in your house. So it might be called something like Netgear or, that's your SSID. And it found one here. Mine in my house, I've named mine Berry 1. But if I want to choose a different one, I can go up or down with these arrow keys here. So I'm going to go down, and now it's found Berry N. I want to set it up on that second network. So then I click on the OK button because that's the network I want. It says, now what is the network key? Now that's the passphrase or the code that you'd put in to log into your network. So I'll do that now. Now after you've inserted the passcode or the passphrase to enter in your network, you then click on the OK button. And now it's going to ask you, apply these settings. And you press up, it says, okay, connecting to the WLAN now, it says. Okay, now it says connected. So it's connected to my network that's in my house.
Now that was the finish of part one. So we've set up our printer with our network, and now we have to set up the printer to work with our computers. And the easy way to do that is go to the manufacturer's website of whichever printer you have. So in this case, it's Brother. And we want to find the printer driver so I can load it onto my Windows machine. Now, to find the printer driver, I just went up to the Google search and I typed in Brother printer driver HL3170CDW, and I found the printer driver. So it says download, select your operating system. So you have a Windows, and then select the OS, it's Windows 10. And then you key on search, and it comes up to this window here. It says full driver and software package. And all I need is really just the printer driver. So that's a smaller size there. So I'm gonna click there. And then it comes down, it says agree and download. Alrighty. Okay, and here it comes down here in the corner. Once it downloads, click it to open it. Say decompress. Say okay. After downloading the printer driver and extracting it, what we want to do now is go down here to your Windows machine and type in printers. And let's go to device and printers. And once you're in device and printers, click on add printer. And there it is. My Windows computer has found it. Okay, after it's found it, click on next. And Windows will set up any necessary files on the system. Now we're over here where it says you've successfully added the printer. Okay, great. We could do a test page if you wanted to, but I'll just click on finish. Now what you want to do is, since you've added it now to your Windows machine, you now want to add it to your Google account. Step one is to log into your Google account. So here, just click on a new tab and make sure that you are indeed in your Google account. After doing that, press Control and then tap the P key. Once you press Control P, you then get into this window here. You can go to change, and then there's the Brother printer. And there it is. If you go to look at right here, Google Cloud Print, there it is. So let's print this test page here. And it works.
Woohoo! It was successful. Look at this. It printed the screenshot there. So 7.5 minutes into the video, we were able to set up the printer driver. So what did we do? We took the printer, we set it up to our network first. Then after that, we went into our Windows machine, went into our Google account, and then we found the printer driver for the Windows machine and set all that up. After that, we went in and we went into printer, add printers on the Windows machine. It added it, and then I did a test page from my Google. What Gmail or what Google was doing was it was actually adding the printer to my account at the same time. So when you have a printer and a Windows machine and a Google account, and they're all linked up together, so that you're logged into the Google account on the Windows machine, and the Windows machine is hooked up to the printer, then the Google account will also see the printer. Okay, so now I'm on my Chromebook. So let's see, was it successful? Did my printer become registered with my Google account? Let's see. So I'm going to go over here, and I'm going to type in Chrome // devices. Now this will show me all my devices that I have on my machine or on my account. And there it is, Brother HL3170. Yes, it says the printer is on a Google Cloud Print. Yes, so that means it's been registered there. And let's just try something. Let's try to print out something here. So I'm going to go into my Google Drive. Then I'm going to go New, Google Docs. And once we see Google Docs, I'm going to turn on my menus here. And I'm just going to say Test. And then I'm going to go Control P. So up in that corner there, where it says Destination, click on Change, and then select your printer. There it is, it says Brother. And then I'll click on Print. Printer's coming on. That's a good sign. So we've set everything up. I'm now printing from my Chromebook. And what's nice about it is I can take my Chromebook anywhere in the world, get connected to the internet, and then print to that printer. Alrighty, so now you know how to set up a printer, and yes, it was successful. All right, you know how to do everything with setting up printers now. All right, thank you very much. Now we'll go to the next question. Okay, the next question that we have is about how to see the video and do the lesson all on one screen. So you don't have to use a book, you don't have to use two monitors or two computers. You can be watching the video on one screen up there and do the project over on that side over there. How do you do it? Very easy. Notice that you have tabs up here. So the tab that has the video, take that one out, and see how I'm dragging it away from there. So I simply drag it away and I put it over to the side which I want to show the videos on. And then I can raise it up that you can still see me too. And so you resize it to the size that you want. And then you play your video. Now I'm not going to play the video because I'm doing a lot on this Chromebook already. I'm doing a live screenshot, and then I got YouTube up over here, and I got your project doing so. And I'm also recording the desktop. Okay, there it is. So you're doing the steps, and then over on this side, you can be performing those steps. So you go to, just the way that you do it, you go New Tab. You always start New Tab, just to let you know. For my students, it's 100% easier if you just go New Tab for everything. That way you don't have to try to refine everything. You just go New Tab, and there it is. There's the apps. Click on Apps, and we always go to the Google Drive. That's 100% of the lessons right there. Is we always go Apps, Google Drive, and then from there we have to find our project folder. Now this is my account, so I don't have the same type of project folder as you do. If I go down my list, I do have new projects for Selma. So double click into your project folder, and then you'd go in and you click, of course, once you're inside your project folder, and the question might come up, say, well, how do I know I'm in my project folder? Well, it says My Drive and then New Projects Selma, or in your case, it would probably say My Drive Projects Folder. Then we go New, and we choose Google Docs. After it opens, first thing that we always do in all of the projects is we give the document a name. So we click up here in the corner where it says Untitled Document. And when you do that, it should become highlighted in blue. Okay, now once it's highlighted in blue, you just simply type in the new name, such as Project 8, or whatever project that we're working with on the video. It'll tell you what to do. And then you click back into your document and you've renamed your document. You can then do the other steps. So that's how you can watch a video on one side and do the project on the other, as well as do a live streaming and doing a video capture of your desktop all on a Chromebook. Alrighty, we'll now go on to the next question. The next question that came up is concerning our menus that you see on the top of any of your spreadsheets or your Google Documents. There's different ways to hide those and to reveal those. If I went full screen, so I've hit the full screen key on a Windows machine, that's F11. On a Chromebook, it's the key just above the 5, and it looks like a little square with arrows. And that's what we get. And then I hit it again and it goes back down. So that was full screen. If I click on the little carrots, they go up. If I click down, it does that. If I go to view and I go full screen from here, then that's what you see. You don't see carrots, you don't see anything. The only way to get out of this is to press escape, and then that gets you back out. So those are the three ways to hide and reveal your menus. The shortcut is Control Shift F. So you press Control Shift and then the F key. And what that will do is that hides the menus, and it's the same shortcut to reveal the menus. And then again, it's the carrots, or you press the key on your keyboard. If it's a Windows machine, it's the F11. And if it is the Chromebook, it's the key just above the 5, which looks like a square with arrows. So hopefully that answered the question on how to show and reveal menus. Okay, the next question came out about which Chromebook do I recommend? Well, there's many Chromebooks that I've tested and used. The best one by far was the Acer Chromebook 15 CB5 571, and that's what I'm using right now to do the recording. And I have this window above me there, and I have this window over here on this side. Let's see how much they are. I paid about $165 or $170 for this particular one, and I bought it at Groupon.com. Now if I just go to Google and type in Acer Chromebook 15 CB5-571, we find there's many places to buy it. Now, the one that I have in front of me is refurbished. And people ask, well, Mr. Barry, why don't you just buy new? There's a good reason. I used to buy new. And every time I bought, the majority, let's say I would buy maybe 20 or 30. Yes, I buy that many because I buy them for my students. Let's say that I buy 20 or 30 laptops or Chromebooks or whatever. There would be a number of those brand new that would not work. I'm serious. It just won't work. I would end up packaging those, sending them back, and then getting refurbished ones anyway that work perfectly. So I kind of wised up, and I only buy refurbished ones because they're guaranteed to work. They've been tested. They actually had someone who looked at it at Acer and said, oh yeah, this one works. It's good to go. Whereas brand new, I don't think they test them. I'm sorry. They might, but out of many, many units that I've purchased, some were not working when they were brand new. But on the refurbished one, every single one of the refurbished ones works perfectly. And he said, well, what'd you do? Buy 10, buy 20, buy 30? No, we're talking, I got 120 students every year. And so, yeah, I'm buying a lot of these every year. So I did a Google search. I typed in Acer Chromebook 15 CB5571. And here's one at different stores. So we can get it, and it says refurbished on there for some of these. And you get them with different RAM amount. Mine has 4 gigs of RAM, and I have the 32 gig drive. So this one right here sounds very similar to what I have. But you just look at each one and pay the price that you want to. Also, if you trust the vendor, I chose Groupon.com, and every one of them comes with a stamp on the underside of the Chromebook, and it says this has been refurbished. Here's the information to register your product for the warranty. So they still have warranty on them from Acer, not just from some guy out there. And so we're seeing a lot of different prices here. Just to let you know, it's what I'm using to record the video on, and I'm very, very happy with mine. Now, if you wanted to go boom, you know, full-blown, brand new, well, sure, you can do that. What would I recommend if it's brand new? Probably something like this $300 one. Or this $550 one with a Core i3 processor, 4 gigs of RAM. Sure, go for it. 32 gigs SSD. Yeah, that's basically what I got for less than $200 though. A little bit different processor. My processor would be this one here, I believe. It's either that one or I think it's a faster one though. There's a way to find out. And just click on new tab, as we do for everything, and then go Chrome:// and type in system. And then it's going to give you all of the system information and system specs for whatever you're using. Okay, now we have about system, and that was fine again with Chrome:// system. There's so much information about your memory, your SSD, and even the chips that are used inside, like which Wi-Fi chipset and everything else. So what we're going to do is just go hold the control key and then tap the F, and notice up there, this is what you want to find, and I go CPU, and there it is. It's an Intel Celeron CPU 3215 running at 1.7 gigahertz. So that's what I'm using. And if I go expand on the CPU info, it gives me more information on that CPU. Alrighty, so now we know exactly which CPU I'm using within my Chromebook. Hopefully this has helped you to have a recommendation on which Chromebook I like. And remember, I go to Groupon.com. I also go to Newegg.com. I go to both of those places to buy a lot of the Chromebooks. Alrighty, let's go on to the next question. The next question that comes up is, do I have pets? And I do. I have a Chihuahua. Here's my Chihuahua. And she is a Deerhead Chihuahua. And she's about three and a half years now old, and she's had a litter. One just jumped down. And so, and her name is Kulo. And the litter is half Chihuahua and Fox Terrier. So the Fox Terrier looks just like this one here. Has a longer tail there. And so these are half Chihuahua and half Fox Terrier puppies. They're 9 weeks old, And this one is Ushi. This one is Kuma. And the mama is, her name is Kudo. So those are all Japanese names, as you can probably tell. Kudo means black, like black fur and stuff like that, that's black. And then Kuma, that means bear. So he's a bear. He looks like a bear anyway. And then I have Ushi. Ushi, she is, looks like a cow. But she looks just like Daddy, who is a small fox terrier. Alrighty. Well, hopefully I was able to answer a lot of your questions today. And please give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.